1811 and 1812, the New Madrid fault line triggered a series of massive earthquakes that reversed the flow of the Mississippi River and shook the entire nation. These were some of the strongest earthquakes to ever strike the United States. And once again, this seismic time bomb is about to go off. Experts warn that the New Madrid fault line is one of the top earthquake risks in the United States, right up there with the San Andreas and Cascadia faults. If this earthquake occurs today, it will have a devastating impact on the region's millions of people, with entire cities potentially reduced to rubble and countless lives lost or forever changed. Memphis, St. Louis, and other major metropolises are sitting ducks, completely unprepared for the devastating earthquakes that ravaged the region two centuries ago. The lack of preparedness is astounding, and the clock is ticking. But what is the true scale of the catastrophe if it occurs now? And what can we learn from the devastating 1811 and 1812 earthquakes? Join us as we explore the forgotten history of the New Madrid earthquakes and expert predictions that will have you ready for the worst. An unexpected episode occurred in 1811, barely 9 days before Christmas, and sent shockwaves across the United States. That early morning, the people of Asheville, North Carolina, woke up to find the ground shaking violently. Although the shaking was not powerful enough to inflict substantial damage or death, it was a frightening experience for many people who had never felt an earthquake before. An eyewitness report of the event was published in a local publication a few days later, which may have appeared ordinary on its own. What made this event remarkable, however, was its widespread impact. Similar articles appeared in newspapers nationwide. The Alexandria Gazette wrote that 20 acres of land sank unexpectedly during heavy shaking, and the tops of the trees were on a level with the surrounding earth. Then more news from Natchez and Charleston in the south to Washington, Pittsburgh, Detroit, and New York in the north. To put it into perspective, the distance was equivalent to that between Los Angeles and Vancouver, Canada. It was reported that President James Madison felt tremors at the White House, and it even caused some cracks in the Capitol building. That night it appeared that the entire United States had been shaking, and this was only the beginning. Massive earthquakes continued to occur regularly for about 2 months, ending in February the following year. As people struggled to understand the source of these tremors, news traveled slowly from inland to the East Coast. As letters and newspapers arrived, it became clear that the further west they came from, the more dramatic the accounts were. The most terrifying stories came from the Mississippi Valley and the new Louisiana Territory. The people of this region experienced a series of earthquakes in the winter of 1811 and 1812 that were both remarkable and horrifying. Over 2,000 earthquakes shook the region, with some reaching magnitudes of 7 and even 7.5 or greater. These were, by many measures, the strongest and most powerful earthquakes ever to occur in the contiguous United States. And they happened in a very unusual place. Not along the West Coast, but in the center of the country, near the town of New Madrid. What's perhaps even more surprising is that more than 200 years later, we still don't know exactly what caused these earthquakes, but still, there is a lot to unwrap. Now, scientists are sounding the alarm as recent data suggests that the Madrid fault line is on the cusp of another major event. The ground along the fault has shown signs of increased activity, sparking concern among experts and residents alike. In recent years, researchers have observed a disturbing trend: a surge in seismic activity in the New Madrid seismic zone. The United States Geological Survey explains that while small tremors and shifts along the fault line may not be easily visible at the surface due to erosion and deep river sediment, these subtle movements signal a concerning buildup of stress that could ultimately culminate in a devastating earthquake. The clock is ticking, and the region is woefully unprepared for the catastrophic consequences that could strike at any moment. To fully grasp the implications of a major earthquake in the region, we must delve into the past and explore what happened during previous earthquakes. Keep watching as we explore the history of the New Madrid earthquakes, the current situation in the region, and the realistic threat posed by a potential next earthquake in New Madrid. To begin, let's take a moment to explore the notorious seismic giant. Tucked away in the heart of the United States, the New Madrid seismic zone is often overshadowed by its more famous counterparts on the West Coast and in Alaska. But don't let its relatively quiet demeanor fool you. This region, spanning across Missouri, Arkansas, Tennessee, and Kentucky, is a seismic powerhouse that has the potential to disrupt the lives of millions of Americans. To understand the origins of this geological giant, we need to travel back in time to the Precambrian era, a whopping 750 million years ago. It was during this period that the supercontinent Rodinia began to break apart, creating a rift valley that would eventually become a weak zone in the Earth's crust. This ancient rift, now buried deep beneath layers of sediment from the mighty Mississippi River, is the reason why this region is surprisingly hilly amidst an otherwise flat topography. The Mississippi River, the lifeblood of this region, winds its way through the heart of the New Madrid seismic zone, creating a broad alluvial plain that serves as a crucial artery for commerce, agriculture, and transportation. The river's floodplain, characterized by rich, fertile soils, has historically supported extensive agricultural development, with vast fields of cotton, soybeans, and other crops stretching across the landscape. But as you venture away from the river, the terrain rises gently into the Ozark Plateau to the west and the Appalachian Mountains to the east, offering a stark contrast to the flat floodplains. These uplands, with their rugged hills and forests, showcase the variety of habitats and ecosystems present in the area. The Ozarks, known for their captivating landscapes with numerous caves, springs, and sinkholes, contribute unique geological features that add to the region's topography. But it's the seismic zone itself, defined by its underground faults, that has subtly influenced the surface geography. Earthquakes have altered the course of rivers, including the Mississippi River, created new water bodies, and reshaped the land through liquefaction and landslides. These geological events have left behind a landscape that bears the scars of its history. What makes this seismic activity in the New Madrid seismic zone so intriguing is that it's characterized by interplate earthquakes, which occur within the interior of a tectonic plate rather than at the boundaries where such events are more common. This mystery baffles scientists as these earthquakes occur far from the edge of the North American plate. Unlike other seismic zones, the New Madrid zone is not defined by a single fault line, but rather by a network of faults that crisscross the region. These faults are hidden beneath the Earth's surface, making them difficult to study and fully understand. It's for this reason that few people have ever really experienced a major earthquake to hit this region, despite its history of causing significant damage. But history has shown us that the New Madrid seismic zone is a force to be reckoned with. Today, it remains a significant concern for geologists and emergency planners alike. Although it hasn't caused any issues recently, the region's history has shown us just how destructive it can be. The New Madrid seismic zone may be a hidden giant, but it's one that demands our attention and respect. But if you doubt, let's look at the accounts of eyewitnesses. Hey guys, just a moment before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell. You'll help us to make products of even higher quality. First-hand narrative of a survivor of the 1811 quake. Now, let's turn to a rare and captivating first-hand account from someone who lived through the 1811 earthquakes. In a letter to the editor of the New York Evening Post, this individual shared their harrowing experience, providing a unique glimpse into the terror and awe that gripped the region. This account comes from William Pierce, who was traveling across the Ohio and Mississippi rivers with a group of flat-bottom vessels on their way to New Orleans. They had anchored near New Madrid when the first earthquake struck, and Pierce's detailed description of that night vividly depicts the chaos and fear that had followed. Pierce and his crew were awakened at precisely 2 a.m. by a severe shaking of their boats. They initially assumed they'd crashed with a sandbar. In a panic, the crew dashed to the deck. Pierce quickly realized this was no ordinary river hazard, but an earthquake causing the turmoil. Aftershocks confirmed this, lasting for about 8 minutes. The tremors were so powerful that even the leaves on the trees trembled, showing the quake's widespread impact. Nearby, a large oak tree split in half, with the top portion collapsing toward the river. The forest around them swayed like slender reeds in the wind. The sound of branches crashing together echoed loudly, like a strong gust of wind blowing through a dense bamboo thicket. They faced a tough decision: stay in this dangerous location for the night, or risk navigating the river's many obstacles. After careful thought, they decided it was safer to stay put. As morning came, another earthquake hit, even stronger than the previous one. Luckily, they had stayed. The ground they had just left split apart and collapsed into the river. Trees were uprooted and hurled into the water with such force that their boats would have been destroyed if they had been moving. In the daylight, the true extent of their danger became clear. During the first four quakes, booming sounds from the other side of the river resembled cannon fire. Initially, they thought the riverbanks were collapsing, but the fifth earthquake revealed the truth. Volcanic eruptions along the cracks spewed fiery material into the sky. The earth rumbled deeply, and the once clear river water turned muddy and violent. Near their boat, geysers of air and water erupted from the river, shooting mud and debris up to 30 feet high. These geysers appeared throughout the area, some reaching astonishing heights. Ancient trees, which had been submerged for a long time, were thrust upward with force. Some landed upside down, while others were blasted into the air, and a few simply floated to the ground. It was an awe-inspiring and scary night, fraught with the possibility of death. They watched in horrified silence as nature seemed to unravel. Throughout the day, the ground kept trembling, accompanied by a constant symphony of explosions that sounded like unending thunder. The riverbed shifted constantly, and the water churned without pause. Their boat was in grave danger, especially where the water boiled just beneath them. Luckily, these boiling spots didn't trigger eruptions. If one of the geysers had erupted directly beneath their boat, it would have meant certain destruction. The deafening sounds of trees crashing down were relentless. Entire sections of the riverbanks collapsed into the water, engulfing everything. It was shocking to see the once mighty trees, which had weathered countless storms, tremble violently and collide. Many were uprooted and thrown with incredible force into the river. One massive tree, 3 feet thick, was launched over 100 yards from the shore into the river, becoming a hazard for any vessels navigating those treacherous waters. Several small islands vanished completely, suggesting more would soon follow. As they continued down the river, all they encountered was devastation and chaos. But miraculously, they escaped the devastating fate that befell millions, who tragically lost their lives in this catastrophic event. And to this day, the mighty Mississippi Valley was transformed by these massive tremors. When should we expect the next earthquake strike? The New Madrid Fault Zone's geological structure is a complex layering of sedimentary rock, including limestone, which amplifies and spreads seismic shocks, much like the reverberation of a bass drum. This unique composition means that an earthquake in the region would travel farther and cause more destruction than a similar magnitude quake on the West Coast. Today, the active New Madrid Fault Zone poses the highest seismic risk in North America east of the Rocky Mountains. While the region experiences an average 200 earthquakes annually, most are too small to be felt. However, the area can expect a magnitude 3.0 earthquake about once a year, and a magnitude 5.0 or higher quake about once a decade. Despite the unpredictability of earthquakes, scientists can calculate the likelihood of a major event based on past seismic activity. Geological evidence suggests that an earthquake with a magnitude greater than 7.5 on the Richter scale could occur every 200 to 300 years in New Madrid. Seismologists estimate a 25-40% probability of a severe earthquake, 6.0 or higher, striking the region by 2040, which would result in significant damage and loss of life. The consequences of a massive earthquake on the New Madrid Fault would be catastrophic. Thousands of lives would be lost, tens of thousands of structures would be destroyed, and millions would be left homeless. The disaster would be a nightmare from which there would be no awakening. Since we cannot predict when the big event will occur, our best course of action is to prepare by implementing extreme safety measures across the entire region. In recent years, the Federal Emergency Management Agency, FEMA, has taken steps to bolster earthquake preparedness in the central United States. Recognizing the potential impact of a major earthquake in the region, FEMA provided funding to the Central United States Earthquake Consortium, CUSEC, to lead an initiative focused on enhancing the earthquake response plans of the 8 states most at risk: Alabama, Arkansas, Illinois, Indiana, Kentucky, Mississippi, Missouri, and Tennessee. The goal of this effort is to develop, improve, and integrate the emergency response strategies of these states, ensuring a coordinated and effective reaction in the event of a significant seismic event. However, that's still very small when compared to what is at stake: millions of human lives. Do you think the New Madrid region will experience an earthquake anytime soon? Is there a region you think is more prone to a more urgent earthquake? Share your opinion in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Click on the next video that pops up on your screen. It's fascinating.